The following energetics question is about activation energy, and the question is at which state in the free radical substitution of methane, whatever this is a mechanism that you're going to study in organic chemistry. So he's given you the steps of the different steps in the reaction. Which state in the free radical substitution of methane by chlorine will have the lowest activation energy? So we need to figure out which reaction is going to have the lowest activation energy. Remember, activation energy is the energy needed to start a reaction. And why do you need activation energy? The reason why you need activation energy is because you need to break the old bonds first. So old bonds are broken initially. Whenever you have a reaction, most of the time what happens is that the first thing that you need to do is you need to get rid of the old bonds. Only then would new bonds would be formed. So old bonds are broken, and this process is endothermic. It requires energy. So activation energy is the energy needed to break old bonds. So we just need to figure out qualitatively which reaction is going to have the lowest activation energy. So if you look at the first reaction, and if you look at the reaction and focus on the reactants and the products, you are going to notice that in this reaction, you need to break the Cl-Cl bond. That needs to be broken. Only then can the reaction proceed. That's the first step of the reaction. You need to get rid of the Cl-Cl bond, because in the products, the chlorine is not bonded with the other chlorine atom. So that bond is broken. So that's your initial step. So there would be some amount of energy needed to break this Cl-Cl bond. So this reaction is going to have some activation energy. But if you look at the second reaction, you would notice, if you look at the reactants and the products, you would notice that no bonds are actually being broken. There's a Cl-Cl bond that's being formed. So in this reaction, no bonds whatsoever are broken, which means that this reaction doesn't need energy initially. It doesn't need energy to break bonds. Hence, this would be the correct option. It would have the lowest activation energy because it doesn't need any amount of energy to break bonds. The whole reaction doesn't involve bond breaking. So this would be your correct option. But let's confirm the other two options as well as being incorrect. If you look at this reaction, you will notice that CH4 over here gets converted into CH3, which means that some energy would be needed to break the CH bond. So this reaction would have some activation energy. Similarly, if you look at this fourth option, option D, you would notice that in this reaction, you need to break the Cl-Cl bond. So energy would be needed for breaking of bonds. So in options A, C and D, there would be some energy needed to break bonds, but in option B, no energy would be needed to break bonds because you're not breaking bonds in the reaction. So no bonds are broken, hence it would have minimal activation energy. A very, very tiny amount of energy would be needed, or not needed at all, because it doesn't involve bond breaking.